So I just woke up and it's six something in the morning, wide awake. And yesterday I got this epiphany. And you know, when you hear stuff and it's like cliche and people say it all the time and you think, yeah, that's great, I know that, but it doesn't do anything to you. It doesn't change your thoughts, it doesn't change your perspective, it doesn't make you better, it doesn't help you at all. And I have had that my whole life with this thing. And yes, my hair is a hot mess because it just got up. But anyway, I just felt like I have to share this. I have to get this out. So I haven't even had coffee yet, and I'm wide awake, and I'm out watching the sunrise, and it's so cool outside. It's so cool and breezy, and I love it so much. Fall is here. Okay, so anyway, focus. So people tell you stuff. Well, yesterday I'm sitting at a stoplight, not worshiping, not praying, not reading the word, not doing anything spiritual whatsoever, just being, which there's spirituality in that, but I was just being and waiting at a stoplight, and it hit me. And it just like blew up in my spirit. And I knew it was God or the Holy Spirit because it immediately changed my perspective. It immediately changed how I thought about myself and how I saw myself and how I felt. I mean, like immediately. And it is nothing I haven't really heard before. It's not new. It's just revelation. And it blew up in my spirit. So, you know how you get all excited and you plan and plan and plan something special for someone you love, whether it's a trip or it's a gift or a fun night together or whatever. You get so excited and you like think they're gonna love it. And so you can't wait to tell them and you're so excited. Well, you tell them and they're like, oh, that's cool, but could we do this? Can we do this instead? Or can I get this instead? Oh, can I use that towards this? Can I get this instead? Can we go do this? Or can I invite a friend? Or can we go do this with somebody, you know? And you're just like, you just spit all over that. I was so excited. I was like really thinking you were gonna love it. And you want to do something else. Or you want something else or something better. And I was like, that is how God feels when I complain about myself. Because He created me this way, even faults and flaws and all. And I wasn't seeing the bigger picture. I was just seeing that I was dissing myself. And it was bad. I'm harder on myself than anybody else in the world. I would never talk to anybody else the way I talk to myself. I would never, ever spit all over, you know, someone else. I would say, look what all you've done. Look at all that you've been through. Look what all you've accomplished. Look what all you have overcome. Why are you hung up on these little things that you struggle with? And I know it was God because people have told me my whole life. People are like, Summer, you've been through so much. And I'm like, yeah, well, I should know better. I know how to eat. I know how to take care of myself. I know how to drink water. I know how not to eat. I know how to exercise. I know the good form. I have done personal training and all this mess with multiple people. I know how to take care of myself physically. And I don't. But then it was like, yeah, you sit for hours on your computer to be productive, to prove your worth. And I haven't given myself credit for all of the trauma, all of the stress, all of the pressure that I have felt on me, not only being a single mom, but running a business and now owning a home and trying to buy my own home and trying to be an adult, just period. Y'all, there is a lot of pressure on us just to be an adult. But not only that, to raise good people to be good adults. We're trying to raise people to be adults, to know how to take care of themselves and other people. And not only that, to be a good, decent human being. That's stressful. Because, like, I watched this comedian. He was like, dude, I made my own people. I made my own people. And they follow me. And now I'm their leader. And it's like, yeah. When they screw up and when they break the law or they, you know, hurt someone else, you're the one to blame. It may not be reality. It may not make sense. But that's what people think. It is on you. And I was just like, you know, we don't think about the stress that that causes on our bodies. And I will wait hours and hours and hours to eat because I'm busy. I'm productive. I'm doing something. I'm in the flow. I don't need to stop to eat. Like, you know, and then, because then it's the whole thing of what should I eat? And then like, ugh, I'm so hungry. Nothing sounds good, but what I should eat. And I can't eat that because I know that it's not going to make me feel good. It's going to hurt my body and I'm going to feel like crap for eating it. So I'm just not going to eat. What? So it slows my metabolism so far down. It makes no sense. So I'm just like, you know, I go into these cycles of, I'll even wait hours to pee. I'll have to pee and I won't get up because I'm busy, because I'm productive and I'm doing something. And that is a proving your worth kind of thing. And so I'm really doing it for a good cause. It's not to be lazy or to beat myself up. It's not to, you know, self-harm on purpose. You know, it's not, you don't deserve to pee. You know, it's not like that. It's, I'm busy. I'm trying to get something done so I can hold it. But that's not good for my body. And I just realized, like, you're not looking at the bigger picture. You're not giving yourself any grace for the trauma that you have. Not only, like, the deaths, the literal deaths of people that I love, that I've experienced, but also the death of a vision of my family and my marriage died with John. I had a hope for us to mend and get back together and our family to be whole, and that died with him. And, you know, that's huge. You know, for everybody having really rough marriages or divorces or separations and breakups and losing your job and, you know, losing a kid, even if it's not to death, but to college or to their friends. Because, you know, when they get teenagers, they want to be with their friends more and more. And that totally makes sense. I did that. I mean, that's just life. That's a circle of life. And that's great because then they're building bonds with other people and they need to do that. But it hurt. I mean, it doesn't hurt, but it makes you sad because you miss them. You know what I mean? That's a loss. And we don't see it like that. We're told, suck it up, deal with it. That's life. It's a circle of life. Deal with it. But in reality, no, for the love of Pete, take care of yourself and make yourself realize you're going through something hard. Give yourself some grace. And that's not an excuse to eat like crap and to sit around and not do anything. But look at me up at 6:30 in the morning after this epiphany, when normally I'd be sitting, laying in my bed, trying to fight through the 6 a.m. wake up. It's already made a difference. It's already made me want to get up and spend some time in the Lord, watch the sunrise, listen to the birds. There is a cock-a-doodle-doo happening. I heard 2 or 3 cock-a-doodle-doos. I've never heard that over here before. Never heard that. I mean, come on. Like, I just, it's so funny because y'all are probably thinking, yeah, I've heard that. Yeah, I've heard. Y'all, I have heard, you know, God gave you that body. You should love it. You should be thankful. God gave you that face. God gave you that hair. God gave you that whatever. And whether you love it or not, you should be thankful because God, you're his masterpiece. Like you're his art that he created and you're spitting all over it. And my justification to being okay with spitting all over it was, yeah, but he didn't make me fat. He didn't do that to me. I did that to me. Not thinking about the stress, the trauma, the PTSD, of things that I can't talk about. I can't even share on here. It's, you know, therapy only kind of stuff. But just, you're not giving yourself any grace. You're just beating yourself up, saying you should know better. But you're human, and I should be thankful for these flaws. Thankful for, because it's my desire to be productive that holds me from keeping or keeps me from doing self-care. And that's not an excuse to not do it. I will do it, you know, and, but it's when you screw up or when you don't do it or when you forget or you get back in your old patterns. Don't beat yourself up. Give yourself some grace because you are human and love yourself the way that you are because God made you that way for a reason. And you're not seeing the good side, you're seeing the negative side because that's exactly what the enemy does. And today's Jesus calling, y'all, the scripture was Hebrews 10:23 again. The scripture was Hebrews 10:23 again. And if you watched my last video, it was just a reminder, you know, 10:23 was a significant date. And Hebrews 10:23 is, let us hold fast to the confession of our hope without wavering, for he who promised is faithful. But also was, tear down every stronghold that exalts itself above the knowledge of God and take every thought captive to the obedience of Christ. And that's hard to do, but that's where the enemy gets us, is in our brain. You're not good enough. You're lazy. You're a turd. When really you're not lazy. You're just struggling with self-care because you're trying to do other things and you're trying to take care of everybody else. And that's actually a sweet thing. That's a good heart, you know, and we're just not looking at the positive. We're looking at the negative. And if you could see it get brighter, it's because the sun's coming up and it's so pretty. And it's so cold and chilly and I love it so much. Anyway, I love you guys and I hope that this is helpful today. It's just, it blew up in my spirit. It may seem so cliche and you're probably thinking, yeah, I know, I've already heard it. But I pray that you get a revelation of how awesome you are. Even with your shortcomings and your flaws and your faults and your screw-ups and your mistakes. Like, I hope that you get a huge revelation of how awesome you are and how many good things that you can do and how many gifts and talents that you have that are awesome that may be getting in the way, you know, as being distracted by taking care of everybody else is how, why we don't take care of ourselves. But anyway, I love you guys. And I hope and pray that you have an awesome day today and more revelations come.